Hi there, Terry Bailey, Senior Minister, Indian Run Christian Church in East Canton, Ohio. I want to start today a little series on the book of Ecclesiastes about living in depressing times. And this will be different than things I have done previously on this venue because you have to be patient and kind of wait with me to get to the end. I don't exactly have the good news encapsulated at the end of each session. I always remember a time that I taught a Wednesday evening Bible study on the book of Ecclesiastes, and it was so depressing, and I kept saying, wait, it will turn around. And one lady just couldn't wait. She didn't make it past chapter 4 and never came back to Bible study after that. So I just warn you, the book of Ecclesiastes is a very good summary of one man living in depressing times. That man was Solomon, and he begins the book like this: "Vanity of vanities," says the preacher, "vanity of vanities, all is vanity. What advantage does man have in all his work?" You do all this stuff, and what benefit do you get from it? It's all just uselessness and striving after the wind, Solomon will say. Let me try to break down the elements of his complaint as he expresses them through the book. Number one, if you were to skip ahead to chapter 1, verse 15, Solomon more or less complains, "This world is broken, you can't fix it. Do whatever you want. Work as hard as you can. Do this good, do that good, but you will not straighten out what is crooked or mend what is broken. The world is, in that sense, beyond remediation, and it stinks." Second, if you were to go to chapter 9, verse 11, Solomon complains, "In a fair world, hard work and discipline and the application of wisdom would ensure that a person gets ahead. But it doesn't always work out that way. Sometimes circumstances that you have no control over intervene, and because of those circumstances, it turns out that the lazy person, the foolish person, the person who didn't even try to do all that good that you have worked so hard to accomplish is the one who comes out ahead, and it isn't fair. Furthermore, Solomon complains, if you were to go to chapter 5, verse 11, he said, "You work extra hard to produce extra good, and other people just line up to consume it, to take advantage of it, to live on the overflow of your excess work and virtue when they didn't make a contribution themselves." And finally, and you can take this all through the book, but Solomon complains, "Everybody dies. The good die and the evil die, and there is no difference. The just and the unjust, the wise and the foolish, the same death comes to claim them all. How is that fair? And when you die, all of the things that you have worked to produce, you can't take any of them with you." Chapter 5, verse 15, "And after you die, no one will even remember all the good that you did." Chapter 1, verse 11. "And after you die, the next person in line is almost certainly going to make poor use of all the things that you left behind and probably break all the good you have accomplished to smithereens." Chapter 2, verse 18. This state of affairs left Solomon profoundly depressed. He doesn't seem to be even the same man who wrote the book of Proverbs. He's broken and cynical and nearly suicidal. And some of the things that he says ring true to us. It can all be so arbitrary. There's this virus that lives in bats in China, and somehow it gets loose. And consequently, my retirement funds are losing all the money that they've made in recent years, and your restaurant business is being destroyed, and all those social contacts on which you count have been denied you, and you're going to bury a couple of people that you love. And even people who exercised and watched their diet and took vitamins and did everything that they could to be healthy and ahead of the curve so as to lengthen their life are going to die because this virus got loose and this arbitrary turn of events that began a long way from here among people that we don't know their names and couldn't pronounce most of them correctly if we did know them, in a land we will most of us never visit in person. This odd circumstance just unwinds the good of all our efforts. To that extent, we can understand and empathize with Solomon. Now, I know it's going to seem like I'm ending on a bad note, but let's just start with that. In our times, we can empathize with Solomon about the arbitrary way that evil circumstances in the world seem to undo all our good works. Begin there and pray with me if you would. Father, I just pray that you give us this comfort. Others of your servants have stood where we stand. And I pray that you also give us comfort that as you dealt with your servants in those times, so you will deal with us today. And I pray that you help us not to feel completely lost in these times, but to look above these arbitrary and capricious circumstances. And I ask this in Jesus' name. Amen.